place-based care and the delivery of that around identified neighbourhoods. And we're currently working with the emergent primary care networks to ensure that those primary care networks, the GPs and other professionals, actually align and support that work, as we very much believe that actually the delivery of good health and care in its wider sense is actually more than just what the NHS or statutory services provide. I think the data suggests that in terms of key determinants of health, people's health and care is only influenced about 10%, but it is influenced by those sort of services. So we have to think about where people live, where people work, where people have their leisure time, where people are educated and so on. And therefore that is very much shaped how we've moved forward with social care services and transferring those, as I cited earlier, to all age disability provision and into other organisations. The paper also sets out a challenge for the next year about realising the cost benefits of integrated provisioning and reducing duplications of our functions, so actually we're leaning more and efficient. Running costs for the CCG element of the organisation need to reduce over the next, by the start of next financial year, by some £800,000. So therefore actually coming together and doing things once is not only more efficient financially, but it's actually better for local people, because we can actually focus our resources much more clearly. I think the paper also sets out very clearly our visions in a number of areas around planned care, around redesigning outpatient service and improving pathways for the disease groups that actually are the biggest killers and the biggest causes of limiting lifelong conditions in terms of respiratory disease, cardiovascular disease and gastroenterology for diseases of the digestive system. To build on the work we've done around learning disabilities and autism and on extra care housing, which you've heard about just now, and about learning disabilities, I'll put these later on the agenda. To improve how we commission out of hospital care in terms of avoiding admissions, ensuring that when people in hospital they only stay there for the length of time they need to stay there for, and to get them home and into a safe environment, or safe home-like environment, as soon as possible, as there is no bed like your own bed. And there is no support like the support the community and the family can bring to you. In terms of women and children, we're still developing very clearly a programme with our partners in children's services around those children who are most in need, but also in terms of the whole population approach on some of the key things such as childhood obesity and child health generally. I've mentioned in terms of primary care, supporting GPs around establishing the primary care networks, but also how additional roles around clinical pharmacy, social prescribing become part of that, but actually we are not layer caking services, so actually we're making best use of the resource. So if we already have social prescribing link workers, and I believe due that the latest data suggests we've got at least 5 to 6 for each of our 9 neighbourhoods, then we actually start to link those in to the primary care networks more effectively. When we talk about medicines optimisation, we're also about actually how we make the best use of the medicines available to us, how we reduce the amount of people utilising antibiotics unnecessarily. If we continue to use antibiotics at the rate we use them as a society, then they will not be effective in 20 or 30 years' time. And some of the things actually we thought we could deal with, we won't be able to deal with. So routine operations will once again become very, very dangerous to take forward. We have to maximise the best use of medicines for people in care, to avoid polypharmacy and to avoid adverse drug reactions in such settings as well. And to also make sure that people make best use of their own medicines and reduce the waste from that. The delivery of emergency treatment centre on the Arrow Park site remains there, and we are awaiting the outcomes of the urgent care review, which will come, I believe, into the July meeting, and the outcome of the public consultation for that. I think we've made some significant progress around mental health conditions. We've improved access to psychological therapy service. We've done more work around dementia strategy and enhancing our crisis care services. But particularly, I think we had a paper do everything on our own as World Health and Care Commission, and we have to work with our partners across the system, whether they be the large NHS trusts or whether they be not-for-profit sector organisations such as HUK and local groups such as Health Watch and so on. So we're asking that the board approves this and supports this as our business plan for the remainder of this financial year.
Thank you, Simon. Any comments or questions from anybody? No. So we're asked to approve. Is anybody happy to approve? Thank you very much. Next on the agenda is Jason. With the increasing independence and transforming care, the Learning Disability Programme update. Thank you.
Thank you, Chair. This report is quite brief and it's part of a regular update to this board around learning disability and autism services. There aren't any decisions to make, so the board are just recommended to note the report. LHSE are driving transforming care programme. And they're keen that we emphasise the priorities for 2019-20, which link to our business planning and our rural and healthy rural operating plan, as Simon was introduced earlier. So if I can just draw attention to the table under 3.6, this lists the priority areas for 19-20 that we will be working on. This builds onto the existing work programme that we have. So some new areas here that will feature are around children and young people. So we are looking at some improved services for people that experience autism and their families, very much in a partnership and in a co-produced way. It's early days and I don't have specifics to bring today, but that will be an area that will feature for this coming year. Similarly, for adults, we will continue to develop the intensive support service and skilling up our community teams, very much in partnership with our key provider, Cheshire Rural Partnership Trust, to ensure that we have services in the community that can support people in times of crisis and avoid people needing to move to alternative care settings. Under the delivering sustainability section, the first heading there is appropriate hospital usage. From previous discussion at board and previous reports, I'm pleased to be able to update that we have managed to sustain our reduced inpatient numbers within assessment and treatment units. Our target's around 4 for our population size. About 12 to 18 months ago, we had towards 10 people. So we've managed to discharge people and to avoid admitting people and readmitting people to a large degree. And this is to make sure that only the people that really need assessment and treatment within an acute setting get it. So that target continues for this year. We will continue to develop and sustain our community infrastructure, and that builds on the different types of services that we've been commissioning. Simon introduced a report around extra care housing. We've also reported on some specific high dependency supported living schemes that we've commissioned recently. So that's all part of having a responsive and a varied community offer. Workforce is a big priority, and NHSE have been supporting providers, professional and non-professional care staff, to skill up and to train so that we've got people within our workforce and our wider workforce with the appropriate skills to support people with complex needs. So some of it is building on the existing work plan, some of it's new, particularly around autism services. We recognise the need to improve our offer for people with autism. Just moving on to 3.9 in the report, this just lists some key key areas of progress that we've achieved. Again, some of them will be familiar to the board. We're continuing at around 85% of the people with learning disabilities
understood, having had that juxtaposition of discussing resource and sustainability, just wanted to make sure that we were all absolutely clear this is about improving life for vulnerable people. Thank you. Yes, Jason.
Thank you, Sarah. Thank you for making that point. I'd like to just respond to other comments if I may. So through the partnership approach that we've been taking in the last 12, 18 months, it was clear that services and professionals weren't working together and truly in the best interest of the people that were supporting. We identified delays, slow decision making, jostling around financial responsibility, funding responsibility and so on. This is absolutely about best practice. Good case management, person-centred support, and the existence of the core budget this last year and into this year actually makes the work much easier for professionals to carry out, so thank you for making the point.
So I'm quite pleased in terms of how this meeting, the papers of this meeting, have that golden thread for them actually acting as one as healthy Wirral. And if you act as one, you start to create the conditions where you have sustainability of the services because you have them. Have a conversation about how they're delivered. You can then have a conversation about and enact how they improve outcomes of people who utilise their services, whether it be extra care housing or whether it be making sure people are supported in their own homes in terms of learning disabilities rather than being placed out of area. And that means then you have a greater focus on the neighbours and the place. And then ultimately that means actually the resources more effectively spent within the world. Rather than going out of area to other providers or spent in a way that actually doesn't benefit the individual to the maximised amount it could do. I think also in terms of learning disabilities, I think we've highlighted in later in the Healthy Wirral operational plan that the five areas of medicines optimisation commissioned out of hospital care, outpatient redesign and elective reform and neighbourhoods are our sort of five priorities for this year. But Pope John XXIII said that he saw everything, overlooked a great deal and corrected a little. And as World Health and Care Commissioning, we have to do the same. We have to see the whole system. We have to make sure that we're looking after children, young people, people with mental health needs, people with autism, people with learning disabilities. And whilst they're not the system priorities, we've said here, they are a priority in terms of this programme within the Healthy Wirral. Certainly the Learning Disabilities Programme, the housing programme within the Healthy Wirral, we don't have to do a lot of correcting with because they're flying along. They're delivering really, really good outcomes. 85% of people living in their own homes, 300 new extra care housing units, reducing from 10 people to 4 people, the people are living in inappropriate placements that don't meet their care needs. There's some fantastic achievements within this, all through, as we said, working together and creating the right environment which should do so. So very much welcome this report and the previous reports from Simon and that prepared by Graham on the business plan, which signifies that we have much more to do and much more to go on.
Thank you, Simon. Anyone else? Yes, Alan.
I don't want to repeat what's been said, but I think we shouldn't underestimate the amount of work that's been involved in the Transforming Care programme. I've seen numbers across the North West system where these targets aren't being met and haven't been. And we have both the prospect of having achieved the target, which was a real challenge, and good sustainable plans for maintaining that position. So I think well done to all those that contributed to that position.
Yeah, I'd like to echo what people have said. I think some of the